Hi darlings, how are you? This is gonna be for my Scorpios, and this is just a little weekend check-in for you. I'll be using my Robin Wood tarot deck, and then I'm gonna pull you a card from my Shadow and Light Oracle, or the Oracle of Shadows and Light. So let's see what message we have for you. Good fortune. Come on now, these cards are really slippery. I know what you're gonna say, but it's okay. So, Scorpio, this is for you. Seven of Pentacles. You planted a seed. Now you're watching it grow? Or are you starting to see the rewards of it? Has something to do with finances? Change is coming. There's an end of a cycle. And it's coming pretty fast. The Chariot. Not too long ago, you were above your challenges and you were facing them head on. And you found your inner strength. And your wishes came true. Ah, and the Nine of Pentacles. You started seeing those rewards. And you had some celebration. And started seeing things clearly. Or not. What happened? Tell me this is the past, okay? So I got the moon. Everything is good. Everything is so good. And then suddenly. So with three of cups here, I'm thinking, you know, well, okay, the moon, well, this is good. You're starting to see things clearly. You start to see through people, you know, seeking the truth. But then here comes the Ten of Swords. That's like the most painful card, you know. That's like heartbreak. That's like rock bottom. What happened? I got the Four of Swords. The Seven of Swords and the High Priestess. Above the Ten of Swords. Whatever happened with this ending here, Benjamin, please lay down. Whatever happened with this ending here, I think it took a toll on you physically. And you needed to take a break, like a real break. If you haven't taken a break as yet, you need to relax, okay? Just try to breathe. And then I got the Seven of Swords. And the Seven of Swords is like, it can mean deceit and betrayal around you. It could be warning you. It also could be you expecting the worst because, okay, so the Four of Cups looks like this, like you need to take a rest. Over this ending. And then the Seven of Swords looks, you know, like you're looking over your shoulder, like you're expecting the worst to happen. But you need to start using your intuition. I think there might be something negative around you. That's what I think. That's what I feel. There might be something negative. And the High Priestess is here to tell you that you need to use your intuition. All right? We got the Queen of... we have the Queen of Pentacles here. This could be an Earth energy in your environment. This could be a Taurus, a Capricorn, or a Virgo. Whoever this is, you need to use your intuition about, okay? I think this card here, the Seven of Swords, is warning you. The High Priestess is telling you to use your intuition. The Queen of Pentacles likes to handle the money. She's the money manager. She has good business sense. But this is keeping you up at night. I got the Nine of Swords here as well. Now, like I said, this could be Earth energy, who is a Taurus, a Capricorn, or a Virgo, right? And you got the Nine of Swords, and then you got the Page of Pentacles. Through everything, or with everything that's going on here, or however you feel, I think you are aware of this energy, or you have a feeling. Follow your intuition, okay? Things can work out here. And you can find balance, okay? I got the Six of Pentacles. So you can find balance. You're studying the situation. You're manifesting things, good things. It's coming. You're going to find the balance. Whatever that... Everything looks well. Everything looks good. You know? But now, this could be old hurt that you're still holding on to that you haven't released as yet. You know, that's why you keep looking over your shoulder expecting, you know, the worst to happen. So, if that's the past that you're still holding on to... Then I suggest that you need to do a little bit of healing. The past returns for a time. The past returns for a time. Old friends, boyfriends, crushes, places, and situations, or reminders of them. Come up to remind you of either how far you've come or that there's still work to be done in areas you thought were long settled. We all have life themes and we all have challenges and patterns. But the trick is to move through them quickly and to learn from them permanently. These ghosts with masks are here to show you what or who needs an adjustment in your life. A clearing where you make peace with people you feel, a clearing where you make peace with people you feel may have wronged you is in order. None of us is perfect. All of us need to forgive and be forgiven. This is the cause of the indecision you are now facing. The ghosts of the past are haunting you. It's judgment day, and you are more powerful than you know. The time for hiding who you are and pretending to be normal and just like everyone else is done. Okay? I think that coincides with this here. So if it resonates, please accept. If it doesn't, please let it go. I love you guys. You take care of yourselves and we will chat soon. Bye.